Thank you. It's great to be here. So what we did is that all gyms, as you just said, in the U.S., was in the U.S., all gyms here in Norway were closed during the early phases of the pandemic. And we were concerned, of course, as many people are, about the health and well-being of people. At the same time, of course, we were concerned about the virus. So we were wondering specifically how a reopening of gyms and training facilities here in our country would be contributing to the virus spread. And our hypothesis was that given certain measures for increased hygiene, for social distancing, it would be safe to reopen gyms and facilities. So what we did then about 6 weeks ago is that we randomized 4,000 members of training facilities and gyms here in Oslo in Norway to either access to their gym or continued no access, which was the standard in the country. So we had 2,000 people training for 2 weeks and 2,000 people who had no access to their gyms. And at the end of the study, we found that there was no difference in COVID-19 transmission and infection rates or clinical disease, which is hospital transmission, hospital admissions, ICU admissions, ventilator treatment in the two groups. And essentially, there was only one person who got the virus during the study period, and this person was not infected in the gym, but at his workplace. So we conclude that it is safe to reopen the gyms, provided that you have these measures in place that we had. Go ahead.
I wonder how specific this is to Norway and whether we can actually glean anything as it relates to the United States. It sounds like the social distancing enforcements were pretty strict. I don't know if Americans would follow that same sort of requirements. Not sure how many masks were used. And it sounds like the prevalence in Norway was pretty low of the actual disease. So is there anything that the governors here in the States can take away?
Well, it's a good question, Sarah. And so let's start with the measures. We had strict measures for hygiene. We had disinfectants at each workstation, that we asked people to wipe off their instruments and their gear before and after they used it. And we had 3 feet distancing between everybody at all times in the gym and 6 feet for high-intensity classes such as spinning. So basically, we had every other bicycle closed down. And that worked very well. If it would work in the U.S. in gyms, I don't know, but I guess it would. And, of course, we had people there who made sure that the members were compliant. With regards to background transmission during the study, we had background transmission rates of the virus here in Oslo that was pretty comparable with many areas in the U.S. In other words, there was a risk of transmission in the community, but for the people who were using the gym, which are mainly healthy younger people, that risk was not increased by going to the gym.
How important, though, is ventilation and recycling of air in this analysis? I mean, is that not an absolutely key factor which might be irrelevant whether it's a gym or a movie theater or a bar?
Yeah, I think, you're raising an important point. I think the distance between people, especially, of course, when there is activities, when people breathe a lot during endurance activities, the distance is important. So we were saying 6 feet, and 6 feet worked very well in our study.
Dr. Brettauer, interesting study. Thank you for joining us.